Blacksmith Kerax. I have been looking for you.
Artanis. Praise the
gods. Your nerf cords. They must be removed.
It was done by the Dark Templar. I am free of the Kala's corruption. Are there others?
I have saved all that I could. Come, we must escape this world before time runs out.
Escape? How?
The Spear of Adun still rests beneath the ruins of Khor Shakhal. Its generators are ancient, but a phasesmith of your ability will know how to bring them online.
The Spear of Adun. I am honored to have the opportunity. This is fortune we cannot ignore.
Indeed. Come, we must go at once.
Hyrok, we are en route to the Spear of Adun. As long as its generators still function, I should be able to bring them online. Once the Spear is fully activated, we must flee from this fallen world.
The Spear of Adun lies dormant beneath the heart of the Conclave. I had hoped to raise it, to secure our victory against the Zerg. But now, it is our last hope for survival.
Artanis, why do you flee from your salvation?
Celindis, she has fallen under Amon's control. Kerax, we have to bring the Spear of Adun online.
The first power cell is activating, but the remaining four have been disabled by creep.
I see. We have no choice but to clear them. What of our defenses?
Unfortunately, they are without power. However, the Spear of Adun's support systems can aid us. They will allow us to deploy pylons anywhere on the battlefield. We should deploy one here as soon as possible.
Hey guys, welcome back to StarCraft.
I am the heart of darkness.
These photon cannons can defend our Nexus Point, Hyrok. They require only a pylon to function. You can warp in a pylon using the Spear of Adun. Press the Deploy Pylon button at the top of your command screen. Our cannons will now fire upon enemies within range. If they become damaged, the shield battery will restore their shielding.
These defenses will indeed be vital to our evacuation, but our first priority must be to clear the power cells of creep.
Alrighty. So, we gotta go clear this shit out. This mission actually isn't that bad, and I'm gonna give you like a little bit of a non-standard way of kind of beating the mission, which you guys should kind of like. I think it's non-standard at least. Because I'm also trying to find the easiest way in case you're wanting to do it on Brutal as well. The minerals will get kind of tight on this map, so remember the flowchart of me showing you guys fucking build a shit ton of Zealots? Zealots are gonna be... they're okay still, but... you're going to want them in very particular cases. And we're also not going to want to build too many pylons.
We can now transform our gateways into warp gates. This allows us to warp in warriors to any area with pylon power.
Because of the fact that we have like one ability here is deploy pylon right there. We're gonna take it a little bit easy on the pylon construction here. I did make one just because we were about to hit the unit cap, and I don't think it's going to come up in time. So that is our one. And we also have some upgrades to get, but I think we're going to wait on that for a sec. Might get another stalker, though. We are building primarily stalkers and cannons for this mission, and that's how we're going to do it. That's the important part.
Zergling bioforms on approach to our nexus. We must rally our defenses.
You require...
I mean, we have a shield battery here, so it's gonna come in handy. I'll make one more zealot here, though. Don't want to lose too many stalkers. You kind of might want to micro them around. There we go. That should be okay. Alright, so the magic number for making cannons, it's about 5 or 6, and then about 2 shield batteries in every area. So these two ramps are the kind of the first ones we are going to defend. And we would prefer to use our mineral sink for that instead. Which is to just, like, make lots of cannons. Not necessarily over in these areas, but yeah.
I'm detecting unpowered warp gates nearby. Constructing a pylon next to them would restore their power, giving us an advantage. The Spear of Adun's deploy pylon ability would be ideal for this. Of course, our probes can always warp in pylons as well. Warp gate online. We can begin warping in warriors from it immediately, Hierarch.
Alright, I'm just getting us some gas. We have lots of minerals, and we can now go and make, I guess, the rest of these cannons. I don't know how to make these, actually. Maybe something like that? Yeah. Basically, we kind of want all the cannons to basically have, like, a firing line and kind of just shoot upon anything that comes up here. So I'm going to make just 5 here and then, like, maybe an extra shield battery. And that should be good enough to hold this. Let's make apparently we need more pylons. I mean, I don't really want to wait for that, actually, so we're going to make another pylon right here. Be very stingy upon this stuff. I'm telling you guys that right now. You can, like, it's just, you're gonna see how close the mineral count is by the end of this. Oh, and notice how I'm cutting them back into the cannon line I created here. That's also something that you can do to kind of, like, save on resources as well. You kind of get whatever you want. Kind of like do a stutter step kind of a thing. Do one fire. You can also, like, do a lot of blink micro. Now, by the way, you know that whole objective of doing it within 15 minutes? We are totally not able to do that. And now I'm going to chrono our forge, and now so that goes faster. Let's go make more zealots. By the way, these two gateways are just fine, because we're going to get 2 more. By the way, do not skip the optional objectives, because I'm pretty sure it gives you some resources. Now, when you see anybody coming after you, you run back into your cannon line. There's really no reason for you not to do that. We actually may want additional shield battery here. We just lost that anyways. So we're gonna replace that guy real quick. Alright, let's see. More pylons. We're gonna use this guy here. And also what we're gonna do is we're gonna get this probe to make a new cannon line right here. For like the 5. I'm shift queuing all of it, by the way, so it just kind of makes, and I can go work on something else. So, as I said, mostly stalkers.
I'm here.
I mean, the Zealots are kind of a frontliner thing, but we should be running away most of the time. Alright, that's our first one. Now, whenever you take out any of these things, keep in mind that there's probably going to be some attack that comes out.
The second power cell is active. The spear sensor array is reacting.
Do not deny your destiny, Artemis. Your people have finally found true unity.
I'm here.
Sensors online. Shadow. Wait, what is this? Warp prisms approaching our nexus point.
Stalkers, eliminate those warp prisms.
Oh shit. Okay, sorry, I fucked that up majorly. Because I actually should have come there and killed it earlier than that. Don't worry, this because we made this defense line, they only warp in one zealot at a time, so we don't be worried too much about that.
Another pack of Zerglings is approaching our nexus from the south.
These guys are having trouble getting in there. Oh god, these guys are dead. You know, it's probably not the worst thing in the world. Can we get those stalkers up here though? There we go. Yeah, it's just the banelings which are the main issue. It's unfortunate I didn't leave an entrance here, but that's okay. We're gonna just have to remake the zealots, though. Alright. We get our one of our probes here to redo that. Alright, and now we're gonna make actually a cannon line actually over here. So, there's a couple of areas we make it. So we have the two defending the opening to our base, and actually the same probe can come over here and make it to begin with. The opening to our base, first of all. And then we're gonna have two cannon lines with lots and lots of these things, by the way. So, like, look how much I have here. It's ridiculous. And they're gonna defend this entrance, and this entrance. This one's very awkward, but because it has like a stair here, and you gotta kind of go sideways here, but you defend those ones with cannons. Absolutely with cannons. And then we're gonna kind of start to head down here. Once again, just stutter step. I mean, wait until the... You can just wait until, what's it called? Your cannon line is up and then maybe do it, but I'm incredibly lazy. To be honest, the Zealots don't even need to come with me. I probably should just not have them come along. But, I mean, there's just one still in there. Let's make more Stalkers. It's primarily a Stalker mission just because gas is so abundant, but minerals are not. What was I going to say? There is actually bases, one right here and one right here, that has extra expos. But we do not go for those. Mostly because I tried it, and then I thought that it was not worth the resources to do.
It shall be as you say.
Okay, those offensive blanks. I just want to kill that asshole. Alright, and we got another one right here. Put the pilot cut up bar.
I brought another warp gate online. Prepare it for immediate use.
Alright, we're not bothering with over there. We're not gonna continue there because we got some more shit we can do. And this is the nice thing about these little guys is that we can do. We can heal them. And then we're making our next cannon line, which is right here.
You require my skills.
Oh, wait, there's some guys here. We can pincer from behind. Oh shit. Okay, it looks like we ended up doing this instead. We can make some zealots here in front. It's honestly, it's a good thing if you reinforce your cannons like the way I'm doing. Okay, it's fine. You can reinforce them and it's fine. We lost our probe, but we just have to remake them. Not a waste of resources, don't worry about it. Not a big deal. And the reason why I'm not like building too much here is because it is actually the second line of defenses when I'm done with this. And then we do... That's why, like, I have so much invested into here. And then the last one is... Actually, we're gonna go down... I'm gonna make it right here. So, we just went down here for the warp gate. We get all the warp gates, by the way, because I think it leads to some bonus resources and things like that. As I said, this one is extremely awkward. But I kind of managed to make it work. And this one, we're actually going to wait for everything to come out. The other issue here is that, like, it's the platform to get down here is extremely small. Like, this one's really easy to get down, but this one is not. And there's some shit, like, right below it right now. So we're just going to wait a minute for these cannons to come online. This isn't, like, a speed run kind of a thing right, that I'm doing here. As you can see, we already have an abundance of gas. To be honest, I don't even think the second gas is even necessary. To be honest, you could probably skip it. Save some money.
Struggle no more.
Alright.
Be released from your pain.
Now, biggest problems are these immortals. Immortals destroy Stalkers. And this is what you want Zealots to actually focus fire on. But I can't... It's sometimes difficult to do it, and I don't blame you for losing some. Very sad story, but, you know, that's actually the only purpose of Zealots in this mission, I'm gonna tell you now. What do we have here? We have another base, under attack over here. We can set some, like if your warp gates are off cooldown, you can send some units in and that's it. And there's some scouts right there. I don't actually think we need to do anything. Scouts are actually pretty awful against ground. I actually might make an additional shield battery in every single location.
We are one with the
shadows. All right. So we were actually waiting for 75 energy, and that means we can make our last pylon here. And now we have full warp gates, and you can see our minerals are okay.
Well done, Hierarch. All of the abandoned warp gates are now under our control.
All right. So now the plan is to kind of kite people into our stalkers, I would hope. So we kind of go like, hey, I'm attacking you, and then we kind of bring them back up to the bridge. Because this is like, this is not a good idea for surround. Shit. Okay, I totally mismicroed that. Occasionally there's gonna be like some shit kind of coming down. If you blink offensively into this, it could be real problems. Okay, now we're gonna move back. Because I don't like the looks of this.
Very well.
But we're gonna blink like that so all our other units can kind of get a nice surround. Oops, I accidentally started shooting my own guy. Alright, we're doing okay right now. So I just blink micro the fuck out of your units and that's it. Actually, that guy's pretty low, isn't it? It's honestly why I like so many stalkers in this mission. Oh, I did not micro that one. Alright, first off, let's just get ready to get back there. Take these stalkers that you just made, make it, put them up there, and run back.
Against you, even the ground beneath your feet carries the seeds of my victory.
So you can see one spawns there.
Warriors, strike them down. We are not defeated yet.
See how weird and choke pointy this shit is? It's fucking awful. Alright, we're done down here, no reason to go back there. We don't even have to defend those things, it's just whatever. So we kind of like, that is worm spawn here, and actually there's something over there killing that. Okay. Oops, where's the probe? Okay, probe does not come. Alright, so, one here, two here, one here, and one here. And you saw the positioning of my cannons, basically. Even if the Nenus Worm here lived, this would be defended and this would be defended. It doesn't send that much out. But this is why we defend the ramps like that. It's because this will happen again in a more severe fashion when we get the next one. And so the way I have it working is, oh hey, you know, it literally doesn't matter. You know, because we have all that. So I'm going to use my extra energy here because we have no more pylons, no more warp gates to power, so you might as well just use this every time you can. And then we just kill everything. Oops, okay. Totally didn't do that right either. This is why I don't like the Zealots in the front here, because it's just like, because right now, we don't need them to absorb damage, because we're just making a shit ton of stalkers. And we're gonna focus down the Ultralisk. Basically, focus down anything that, like, does a lot of damage. So that would include Ultralisks, Immortals, things like that. Those are the worst things, honestly. If you can, get Zealots to absorb it, but fucking hell. The amount of micro that requires, I'm not even that great at that. You know, because you gotta have them always in the front and things like that. As I said, I like the strategy here of where I aggro things and then kind of pull it down. And then I kind of blink in offensively just to hit that thing. Let's put this guy in the back or whatever. Alright, why is my probe under attack? Why did he come over here? Did I tell him? I must have told him to come down here. Alright, we're gonna just make a couple more of these guys. Oh, we have another pylon we can get. It's off, because we still need it for energy supplies. Oh, okay. This is not good. Yeah, this is the kind of shit that you should be afraid of. Because they actually do a lot of damage. Okay, immortals. So, this is the one time we actually do build zealots. Because these guys do extra 60 damage against armor. Guess what photon cannons are? They are armored. But zealots are not. Okay, that's really bad. This is actually potentially game losing right here. I think that was unfortunate. There was like some that came from behind as well. Alright. Looks like these zealots can come over here as well now. Just bring them over. And actually, these guys can use some healing from this guy as well. We're still making pretty much exclusively stalkers. Just because we have so much gas. That is literally the only reason. Alright, we're ready to go again. As I said, it's gonna be really annoying because like this, like the zerglings right here, what do you fucking do? All over the place. But I think we got it. Let's make some more stalkers over here and run back. Absolutely run back right now.
We're almost finished, Hierarch. The Spear of Adun is nearly online. Only one cell remains.
Enough. The end to the cycle of infinite madness has come. Cease your struggle against the salvation I bring.
There's gonna be some, little things right here. It now combines both. But hey, if you did everything correctly, you're right now laughing, just like I am. And that's it. Kinda just dealt with all of it immediately. And so they just can't get through any of this. So the last one, we kinda just go straight down middle. Assuming we can fit past this, here we go. This is arguably the more difficult, the most difficult one, but it will be also the most fun. I want to save this guy, to be honest. Yeah, you can already hear mineral field depleted. Like, that's it, you're running out. Okay, we may have to go over here. Should also mention, when you're on the last one, like I am right now, don't even bother with the remaking these cannons. In that last attack that we just kind of did, like the last big one that we were just dealing with now, that was the big one. That was the one that we built all this shit for. So that was the entire reason of everything we just did. So okay. Okay, we can now continue. Oh, hey, there's some mineral pickups here. Because now this is all the minerals we have. Intriguing. You must construct additional. Yeah, that's all we can do. But trust me, we're gonna be warping these guys in. Sometimes you just have to suck it up and kill them. And already as it is, we can now rebuild all these ones. So that's why I said 5 is enough, and don't bother with, because like if I made like let's say like 15 pylons or something, now I would be done for resources because this is as much as I'm going to be getting. Hope we stop some hybrids. We're just making our last ones here, because there's really no other place I'd want to put it at this point. I just don't want Banelings to hit most of my Stalkers here. I prefer they hit the couple Zealots I have still left. And this is why I basically said, I don't think it's necessary to get that last, so I'll show you what the minerals is at now, and see, geyser's done, and minerals are basically done. And it looks like we lost a pylon, whoops, because I was showing you guys that. That's why I said, don't even bother going for the next expo, because imagine the amount of resources you have to spend with all the hybrids and shit up there, and immortals. Because this is all the units we can make, so. Anyways, we're done.
Power transfer completed. The Spear of Adun is ready to depart. Among all firstborn freed from Amon aboard, Faysmith. We must flee this world if we are to survive.
As you command.
I didn't mute myself on Discord, so that's the noise you guys heard. My bad. All right, so as I said, the 15-minute thing is it's just play it on normal, and you just build an army and rush it. You don't have to make all the cannons that I did. It's not necessary. It's not possible to get that time down. It really isn't. Well, okay. Now I shouldn't say it's impossible. It probably is, but for the sake of a kind of a brutal tutorial-ish run, just do it on normal. As I said, I'm pretty sure you could, I mean, you could do it if you're like, you just snipe them out and like play like out of your fucking mind, but I mean, as I said, it's trying at times, so yeah, I mean, as I said, the way I showed you, we got it by the edge of our teeth. We didn't have to expand or anything like that, and if you do it any other way, I think it's like a little bit, eh. Whatever, but anyways, let's continue. I mean, these achievements don't matter. Fuck it.
Engineering, and last of the three great Ark ships. Each created to ensure the continuation of our culture in a dark time. Its chambers rest contingents of zealots, Templar who bravely sacrificed, entering suspension so that they may serve as this vessel's army. Though it pains me greatly, I have begun severing their nerve cords. The ship's lower decks contain a Starforge capable of constructing weapons of war. There is much to learn about this vessel. Its technology is ancient, yet highly advanced. We are aboard a relic from a glorious time, when our culture shined as a constellation. The Celestial Array has been updated, Hierarch. From here, you may select our next point of travel.
With this vessel, we will avenge what has transpired, Kerax, and we will free the Templar.
Thank you.
is lost once more. My great vision of reclamation left in ruins. This shall not stand. The Terrans of Korhal have in their possession the Xel'Naga Keystone, which Zeratul foresaw would lead to our salvation. Though I have not seen Commander Raynor in many solar returns, I believe he will give the Keystone to us. The Narazim of Shakuras ritually sever their connection to the Kala. Because of this, they are now the last free Protoss. I must reach them before Amon's armies.
This is Commander James Raynor. Artanis? There, ain't you a sight for sore eyes?
Friend Raynor, you seem rather occupied.
Just another day at the office.
Who are these insurgents?
Call themselves Mobius Corps, an elite guard that used to work for Dr. Narud. They've been striking worlds throughout the sector, leaving few survivors. Each world attacked, reported hybrid leading them.
Then truly, no world is beyond Amon's reach.
Reinforce those bulkheads. Reposition the Mark 7 Alpha. We need to form a battle line. They've overrun Sky Shield, our orbital defense platform. Looks like they've destroyed its atmospheric stabilizers. It's falling fast. If it crashes, it'll obliterate August Grad.
We will ensure that does not happen, Commander. Engage their fleet, and keep their assault at bay.
Like old times, buddy. Like old times.
Hierarch, before our armies engage the enemy, it would be wise to review our military capabilities within the War Council.
It seems fate has drawn us together once again, James Raynor.
I'd call it luck.
Luck is a concept that is purely human in origin. We Protoss see the synchronicity of events and know there is a grander design behind them.
It don't matter how you see it. The result's the same. So what brought you all the way out here, Artanis?
Zeratul believed that the artifact in your possession, the Keystone, he called it, could guide us to the Xel'Naga.
Where's Zeratul now?
The Dark Prelate fell on Ire. His last hope was that I would continue his quest and find a way to stop Amon.
Damn it. Always knew there was only one way this quest of his was gonna end.
His loss is great. I know you called him friend.
I went through hell to get that artifact because of his damned fool prophecies. Lost a lot of good men. If he wanted you to have it, take it. It's yours. Right now, though, we got a city to save.
Kerax, even without the Kala's light, I can sense your sadness, your pain. Does the Spear of Adun bring you no joy?
That is just it, Hierarch. Without the Kala, it is as if I am blind. I cannot sense your feelings, know the true depth of your thoughts. I cannot call upon the surety of other Faesmiths. I am alone.
I feel the isolation as well, as though thrashing within the vacuum of space. But you are not alone, brother.
To think, the Dark Templar have endured this existence all this time. The days ahead will not be easy.
We may not have the Kala to rely on, Kerax, but we still stand as one. We will endure. There is no other option.
Isn't it their psychic link? Then how are they talking to each other? They have no mouths. Nah. fucking starting a huge debate for this. Alright. See our upgrades and shit.
A preserver? Released from stasis?
She still bears her nerve cords. She is tethered to the collar.
Hold. I am Rohanna, Grand Preserver of the Valari, and your War Council Advisor. You must be the Executor in Command.
You are not possessed by the Dark One. How is this possible?
I feel darkness lingering at the edges of my every thought, but I am not corrupted. Preservers of my station have trained to control the Kala's every ripple. I assure you, I will stave off this evil and serve you better by doing so. As all preservers, I hold the memories and personalities of Protoss prior to my submission to Stasis. This will allow me to contrast your tactical decisions with those of past executors. From this chamber, you will be able to make all military allocations.
I am Artanis, Hierarch of the Daylong. I lead all that is left of our civilization. Your memories are indeed of use, Rohanna. But make no mistake. If you fall to this corruption, I will not hesitate to destroy you.
It is understood. I am prepared for the Firstborn's darkest hour. Come, let me show you what may be done here. The assembly panel awaits, Hierarch. We may begin whenever you are ready.
I will talk to her first.
I have heard only tales of the Grand Preservers. I did not expect to encounter one aboard this vessel.
That is not surprising, Hierarch. My sisters and I are unique. Trained from birth to master every intricacy of the Kala. I have experienced its true depth, plunged the infinite spectrum of emotion and memory. It is because of this gift we were selected to enter Stasis, so that we may guide you in our most dire hour.
Your sisters were aboard the other Ark ships? Then they...
are one with the Kala, fallen during the Zerg invasion of Ire. I know this. I feel the tragedy that has befallen us, more deeply than you may realize.
A terrible burden has been laid upon you, Rohanna.
Yet it is my fate to bear it. A fate foreseen by the same minds that constructed this vessel. I trust in their wisdom, Hierarch. I will serve my purpose, much as you must serve yours.
Alright, I see what this is.
The assembly panel allows you to customize your army based on the Protoss technology we encounter. Select a warrior category to begin. Now you may choose one of the two factions for use in upcoming battles. These assignments are not permanent and can be altered as our combat needs change. Many battles await you, Hierarch. Choose a faction and lead them to glory.
We are the Blades of Iron.
For the most part, I'll show you what these are when I get them. And at the beginning of every mission, I'll show you what I have selected. So this is a whirlwind for kind of like the... when you get swarmed by lots of zealots, lots of zealots. And this one briefly stuns things. So we're gonna use the whirlwind actually, because we don't really have much in terms of splash right now. So this would be actually probably the best thing for us. Then we have stalkers.
I'm here in the shadows.
So one of them briefly regenerates shields after teleporting and deals bonus damage to armored units apparently still. So pretty good choice to be honest. And we have Enhanced Rider.
I have returned.
Deals increased enhanced damage, range, and life. So it basically has like I think 120 HP opposed to Stalker's 80. And deals bonus damage to it's the same damage I'm pretty sure. So apparently has a high amount of life at the cost of reduced movement speed. But this also means no blink. And I honestly think that the strongest part of the Stalkers is their blink. You know, you can reposition them in situations they don't want to be in. I would say Dragoons is the lazy man's... if you don't do blink micro, if you absolutely hate it, then don't do the Dragoons, don't do the Stalkers. But the Stalkers have the blink, and then they have, you can make them tankier when you do blink micro. So realistically, they're just better all around. You know, assuming that you actually manage to actually, as I said, blink them around and stuff. And this is just for me personally. If you're not into that, then I would suggest don't even bother just to go to with the Dragoons if you just want to be lazy and aim move them into stuff. So that's it for that. And we will continue the mission next time. So thank you for watching and take care. Goodbye.